Hey guys, DRUSA here. My name is Jason, and somebody wanted me to show how well my DDR homemade cab is. So I'll show you how far I've gone. I haven't done anything to it in the past couple of years. I've been so busy with other stuff in between. But here's a video update on how well my homemade DDR cab is doing. So it's looking rather, sorry about the light, it's looking rather good so far. I still need to do some lot of work. I have a TV. I need to take that out, put some speakers there instead. But in the meantime, I'm also working on a homemade DDR metal pad, just like Riptide's version. By the way, he gave me some pretty good tips. The metal bar I just got from my other DDR pad, and use it off of here. Nothing's mounted on there yet, but it will be soon. It all depends on when. So sorry if the video looks kind of orangey. I just have to set the settings of the resolution, but no big deal. It just helps to see better. So ever since day one, when I was building this thing, or me and my friend, we were building this thing. It needs a lot more work. It's the stand for the sign, or the sign here, needs to be replaced. I have to make a better one, because this was just a temporary version of it. Kind of more like a quick build type-ish. So, yeah. Sorry, guys. I haven't been making any updates on how to build your own DDR homemade cabinet and whatnot. That's because I've been working on some other projects in between. But this is just to give you guys a typical idea on how to build your own DDR cabinet if you don't have that much money to buy a DDR cab for like $3,500 or $3,000. If you ever had that much money. But it is what it is. Thanks to Riptide, who gave me the plans. I found some videos of his that I downloaded with BitTorrent and whatnot. So you can find some of his video clips if you want to build your own homemade DDR metal pad and your own homemade DDR cab. So, originally that I planned to do was to turn my Street Fighter 2 cabinet into a MAME cabinet where I can run OpenIDG on here and put this as my DDR cab instead. Although I might need to change the monitor though. But the monitor is a pretty good monitor, but it's just small, like too small, you know. So it's a good arcade cabinet. Had it for over 3, 5, 6, 10 years, somewhere around there. Pretty good shape, actually. I haven't been working on it lately because of the control panels of the buttons are kind of sticky a little bit here and there. But this just comes to show you how well my Street Fighter 2 cabinet is. But I do plan on putting a JPEG in here, possibly, maybe, and converting it into a PC game mode, so that way I can just do like random emulator games on here and OpenIGG, as I said. But the screen, that's my biggest issue. I don't really like the screen. If this was another homemade built cabinet, what I would do is I would have to, you know, buy some more plywood and get some T-molding here on the side, to be exact, so that way I can make my own specialized DDR, to make my own arcade cabinet, so it'll be just the same, but a little bit bigger, so it could support a 24-inch arcade monitor, and a PC computer board in there, so that way I can run some emulator games on there, and a bunch of other random video games, like over 3,000 games in here or something like that. So that's my updates for now, and on that over there, pretty self-explanatory. I found some tips on ideas on YouTube on how to build your own DDR metal pad, which is pretty awesome though, because I've got a lot of good tips that I can do, you know, hook it up to your PS1 controller. That is if you know how to solder. You gotta learn how to solder first if you want to do this correctly. So, I already took out the board chip, the memory board in here. So, right there. So, anyways, until then, more videos soon, since I got a bunch of other video vlog that I want to do. So, until then, this is my update on my arcade cabinet and on my homemade DDR cab as well. So, I've seen comments on my original videos that are pretty crappy. So, I don't want to see, like, oh, why are you building some crappy, lame piece of crap that is not even gonna work, and you might as well buy yourself a freaking $3,000 DDR arcade cab. Duh. Well, I don't, first of all, I don't have the money to even do so, and second of all, finding a job is very hard to do, and that's why I love doing YouTube videos, because, it's what I do, you know? So don't mock my builds. It's what I do for fun. And that way I don't have to be behind a computer all the time for you guys. It's my finger. Yeah. Pointing. So, alright. Well, there you have it. If I find your YouTube channel, I'll put it on the sidebar there for you guys to go check out his channel. So, well, there you go. Thanks for reminding me about my homemade cab. You know, I'm planning on building another panel, DDR metal pad panel here for two players. We'll see. They're just 2x4s and 3 2x4s squished together. No, I actually make that 4 2x4s like that. And square panels here and there on each side. Self-explanatory. And a bunch of nails for the contact points that Riptide once did. Yeah, so this video is way too long. It's over 9 minutes. Guys, later. Catch you guys later. So, see ya.